especially among the younger crowd.
You get hungry for it, like, you start seeing how fast you can make money, so you want to, like, keep making it.
I'm just kind of, like, hoping on it, almost as a lottery. So I've been checking it, like, daily to see if it goes up or not.
For years, the retail trading app Robinhood has been spearheading a growing financial revolution, pioneering commission-free trades. But Robinhood really took off during quarantine, when more than 10 million new users pounced on it, and revenues rocketed from more than $277 million in 2019 to nearly $959 million in 2020. It was the first in a flurry of new financial apps that novice investors embraced.
So I didn't expect to go into this making like millions of dollars right off the bat.
Julia Arpino was one of them.
I was hoping to kind of have at least some savings in there.
During the pandemic, the 23-year-old biology grad student and part-time zoo worker downloaded the investing app Webull. Like many in her generation, she's demonstrating a more aggressive attitude about money and how to make it.
How easy is the app?
It's very easy. So give me a company.
Tesla.
Tesla. You just put in Tesla, get it?
Yeah.
Trade, I'm not going to buy it. But trade, it's already all set.
I feel like people my age just want everything now.
Dan Bolanos is Julia's boyfriend and an avid online trader. He learned about investing from his father, Ivan, but uses different tools.
The kids, they got their own mind. You know, sometimes they think that they know everything.
I started off with Robinhood because it had a simple interface.
I told him that you have to be very careful.
In early 2021, Julia and Dan got caught up in the GameStop saga.
It's all about your money, money, money.
David and Goliath's story of a struggling video game retailer.
Never seen anything like it.
That sent investors into a buying frenzy.
GameStop has now doubled. The craziest I think I've ever seen.
It was extraordinary to say the least.
The first trade I made with it, I did make like $200 off it.
In a matter of weeks, the stock went from double digits to triple and back down again. The roller coaster spurred on by enthusiastic social media communities.
Did it make you feel more confident that you weren't the only one in GameStop, that there was a whole Reddit army behind the stock as well?
Yeah, 100%. I think it was like a little bit of that camaraderie when you saw all the comments and all the Reddit stuff saying like, oh my gosh, we're all in this together, like damn hand, hold your stock. And then it just tanked. And I kind of freaked out. I'm like, I don't want to lose any more money than I had lost.
What